concerts and nightclubs. I don't know how. We were 16, but we managed to do that. And we started playing all over, traveling on weekends and stuff. And but we listen, man, we were rockers. Okay. We wanted to rock loud, fast, and hard every song all night long. We were prepared to do that. But we started getting hired for a lot of high school dances, and we found out on the high school dances that after the first three songs and every three songs after that, the cheerleaders would all come to the front of the stage. And I found out over here that y'all don't really have cheerleaders. It's a big thing in America, especially Texas, you know. The hottest girls in the school are the cheerleaders, you know. That deal, you know. Pom-poms and, you know, the boyfriends or the quarterback and the big stud linebacker guys and all that. Anyway, we do these dances, and the high school girls, after three songs, they come up to the stage, and every three songs after that, they come up, "Will you play a slow song so we can slow dance with our boyfriends?" "Do you know Ready for Love by Bad Company?" And we did. We played this song. This is embarrassing, but I'm telling you the truth, okay? Listen, we figured out. No, we're not going to do a Bad Company song. I'm sorry. And especially not that one. But anyway, you know, we would have been all tough and everything, but we figured out that the committees that hire the bands for those high school dances were the cheerleaders. So we learned at a very young age that sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do in this world. And it wasn't a bad lesson. And then there's that other thing, after they walked off, we all looked at each other and said, "Cheerleaders just talk to us." It was even dorkier than that. Anyway, I hate to disappoint you cheerleaders out there tonight, but we got a slow song, but it's not a romantic slow song. It's kind of dark and creepy.